Boiler service tips. My name's Alan Hart, and today's video has been sent in from a subscriber, and they've been sent in from Pete from One Plumbing in Essex, and this video is boiler service tips. So Pete sent us a few different videos in, and I've put them videos together, and there's just tips on when you're going to go do a boiler service. As always, always refer to the manufacturer's instructions for each individual boiler, and obviously all your gas safety manuals. Don't take anything in these videos as factual. You must always read the installation instructions. If you've got any videos that you'd like to send in, then please send them in. I will have my WhatsApp details below, and if you want a shout out to your company, then please just put your company details in the message and what you want me to say in there, and you know, and I'll give a shout out to your company. I really appreciate all these videos that are getting sent in. Without further ado, let's have a look at some of these tips. This video is for gas safe registered and trainee gas engineers under supervision. Please comply with the current regulations at the time.
Ideal Vogue service. Do Penilla Mary checks. Check fuse spur. Whoops, wrong size fuse. Check electrical polarity. Isolate gas and electrics, but remember to test gas first. Clean that filter. Check expansion vessels pressure. And recharge if necessary. Detect electrode leads and fan leads. Remove burner and fan. Clean as necessary, including electrodes. Check gas valves and Venturi. Clean condense trap. Clean heat exchanger with soft brush and wash out debris. Lightly lube burner gasket. Replace components in reverse order. Finally, combustion check and flue integrity. Don't forget your working gas pressure. Retest gas. Set your boiler to the most economical range. Dad, are you going to give me that 50 quid now?
You can have some Haribos. So, with these boilers, as many of you know, the condens traps are these ones. They're not always easy, you have to shake them about a bit. So my little tip for cleaning these out is actually attach your own hose to the bottom of the sump, and then you can rinse out that heat exchanger without any crap going back into your condens. That's the way I do it. And maybe use a bit of white vinegar as well. This one's a little bit crusty now. A bit of white vinegar on the inside of that heat exchanger. So it's been sprayed with white vinegar. A bit of cardboard in the back to protect your insulation pad. Yeah, it's a little tip I got off of someone on Instagram. I didn't even ever think about that. But not, they're not all removable. But like I say, if your readings are okay, still open these up on every service. It's a bit like the Worcester. You read on the fan pressures. If the fan pressure's all right, your heat X don't need to. I have done loads of fan pressures on Worcesters, on the RIs, and the fan pressures are okay. And you open up the heat cell and they are obliterated. So take no notice of that. If you can take them apart, give them a good strip down and clean, do it. They need it. So my mate said to me the other day, he said, these Ideal filters, you can't dose them like a Magna Clean. You can. On that nut, just turn the whole thing round so this is at the top. Take it off, dose it, easy. Yeah, just dose it. Put the bottom at the top and dose it that way. Easiest way to dose a system. Another little thing, on commissioning we know, first half hour, let all the oils burn off. Yeah, run the hot water. Same with a gas rate. Do a gas rate, you have to wait 10 minutes before you gas rate it. Best advice, run the hot water for 10 minutes, then put it into your high commissioning mode. That way then, the burner's been open for 10 minutes to full capacity, and then you get a true gas rate. You won't have the problem of the boiler modulating and shutting down, going down into a lower rate. So always run the hot water off first before you do any commissioning. And then that way, you'll get a true gas rate on your full commission mode. Milky, milky.
That's a bit better.
These Potterton Golds, I've got a name for being not a great boiler, but that's only because the aftercare on them half the time isn't there. If they're maintained yearly, these ain't a bad boiler. Brand new sump seal. New gaskets, fan connection. New burner door gasket. The actual room seal's being replaced on this as well. I wasn't very happy with that. But you can see where this seal has failed, you are getting product of combustion showing. Leakage, so that is why we're changing this whole part. Electrodes are going to be changed just because I want to replace this. Yeah, I mean, they're a little bit shitty anyway, but probably better to be on the safe side. This is right moody and you can't get this part without the electrodes. So all back together again. New electrode set, new door seal on the inside. new fan, burner seals, even the room seal needed changing. So now I'm going to just do some tests and run her up. Very clean indeed. Apparently, if you was in a pub when smoking was all the rage, apparently they have 60 parts per million in that pub. So this boiler's healthier than an old pub, apparently. That's what I hear. Borate 19 millibar. So I picked this up from another engineer on YouTube. It's always nice to let the next person know what's been done, because there might not be any paperwork about. So that's always a good idea for your fellow engineer. Job's a good one. Job done. Another one bites the dust. Hold send, press on, keep send, finger down. You ain't gotta wait for a purge. Yeah, that's if you just wanna do gas pressures and not wanna wait for it to purge. The other thing, these battery charging, yeah? The battery charge, yeah? I thought my battery was knackered for ages. Yeah, because when you put your battery on charge on these canes, 455s, you must press the on button twice. Because if you plug it in while it's working, it's not charging. Even though it says charging battery, it's only doing a trickle charge. And you'll keep going, my cane is not charging. But you haven't charged it right in the first place. Remember, always read your instructions, you plumbers. Oh, have you ever done this? You go to turn the light on and you turn it off. Ah! Oh no! It's turning off now. It's turning off. I can't wait another 30 seconds for it to turn off and another 90 seconds for it to purge again. Have no fear. Just press on and send at the same time and it'll get you out of that mode. It only took me 4 years to learn that. That's just me though, so have a good day.
Thank you very much for that, Pete. If anybody else has got any videos, please send them in. I will have my WhatsApp details below. And if you could, please like and share and comment on these videos. It's really helpful. And yeah, thanks for watching, and thanks to everybody who supports this channel. Thank you.